Hey, it's Amber Carnes from Body Positive Yoga here, and I've gotten a lot of questions about Chaturanga Dandasana and Upward Facing Dog. So these poses are really ubiquitous in a lot of yoga classes, but we don't always get a lot of instruction about proper form or how to do them without injuring ourselves. These are poses that take an incredible amount of upper body strength and core strength to do properly. And so if you're attending a vinyasa class, or maybe if you're a beginner or you're still working on upper body strength, these poses can be a little bit, I just say approach them with caution. Chaturanga especially is kind of notorious for being responsible for a lot of soft tissue injuries in yoga. Once the shoulders dump down below the elbows, we start to get the shoulder in a compromised position. It's no longer stable. And then that's when we start to tear things like cartilage or even pull muscles in that we don't want. So what we're going to do is we're going to look at a few different versions of Chaturanga and Upward Facing Dog today and some ways to build strength. So both working at the wall as well as working on the mat with some props in order to build the upper body strength and the core strength and also the awareness about form to so that we can practice these poses with integrity and in a way that we're not going to hurt ourselves. So let's go take a look at Chaturanga and Upward Facing Dog. So what we want to do is learn how to do this pose with integrity and with support while we're building strength to be able to come into the pose fully. So the first place that I like to work on this pose is at the wall, and we'll look at that towards the end of the video. But first, we'll go ahead and look at it in a supported version on the floor. So I have a bolster here. If you don't have a bolster, you can use a firm couch cushion or even a couple blocks or thick books with a blanket laid over it, something like that. And what we're gonna do is use this prop to be able to catch the weight of our body so we can be in the correct alignment for Chaturanga and also for Upward Facing Dog without having to have the full upper body strength to do so. So what I'm gonna do is come forward, and we'll just start in a modified plank to see what this feels like. So knees are behind the hips, wrists are under the shoulders, resist the earth away, and then you're gonna send the elbows straight back as you lower the body down. Now, the bolster caught the full weight of my body, my elbows are back, my shoulders are above the elbows or right at them, which is the alignment that we want to have. And then you can even shift forward and come up into the back bend. So this modified one with the knees down is just to see what it feels like to be low in that cobra position, or sorry, Chaturanga position, and then to come up high. So you can try that a couple times with the knees down if you like. And then we'll come into the more full version of the pose. So for this one, I'm gonna come into a full plank, top of the push-up, so lift the knees, and then lower straight down, elbows come back. Right into Chaturanga. So try to lower as slowly as you can. That will help build strength for this pose, eventually to be done without the bolster. And then you can roll over the tops of the feet, press up, Upward Facing Dog. So just the tops of the feet and the hands are on the floor, but your pelvis is supported by the bolster. And then you can just come on up. So try this with the bolster, see how it goes. You can also do this with a block right at the chest, at the sternum, and get a similar level of support. Then when you're ready, you can try it without the bolster. So what I like to do when I'm working on Chaturanga, which is definitely something I'm very much still working on, is just try to lower down as slowly as possible. So I'll come into plank. And with modified plank, you can always start there, feet, knees still on the ground, and then sending the elbows straight back, just lower as slowly as you can. And that definitely is going to work all the muscles that you need to eventually be able to do Chaturanga without the knees down. And then squeeze the elbows in tight and push right back up. So lower very slowly and then squeeze the elbows in, push right back up. So we can do this same thing with a full plank. So come into high plank. Lower down as slowly as you can, keeping the elbows in tight. Eventually, you might hit the floor, but it's really important to get that lowering down movement to be able to build strength to push back up. And then if you can, just push back up. So we'll come to the wall now and look at Chaturanga and Upward Facing Dog at the wall, which is another way to build strength. Okay, so I'm here at the wall, which is the first place I like to go when we're learning Chaturanga. So this is great for building strength, both for plank pose or Chaturanga, knees, chest, chin, anything where you're lowering down. So first, what we're gonna do is basically come into a modified plank here at the wall. So my feet are behind my hips and my arms are out at chest height. So this is a great way to start working on strength for plank if you're recovering from an injury or anything like that. You're still gonna get the action of resisting away, spreading out through the shoulder blades, pressing the hands down, getting that strength in the wrist that's important for plank. So you can start here. I'm gonna walk my feet in just a little bit and then show you the lowering down motion that happens in Chaturanga. So a lot of times what happens, both on the floor and at the wall, is people try to stick their face between their hands and then the elbows splay out. That's not what we want. We wanna take the chest between the hands. So send the elbows straight back and lower the chest to the wall and then push straight back up. So you can even lower the hands a little bit. We're gonna take the elbows back, lower the chest to the wall, and push straight back up. So keeping the elbows squeezed in really tight to the body, lowering down and pushing straight back up. And I'm keeping a tight midline the whole way down. So squeezing the navel toward the spine, keeping the core really tight, bracing the abdominals as you send the elbows back, keeping them tight into the body and pushing straight back up. When you come down, don't let the elbows come out to the sides. That's not the type of push-up we're doing. We are doing a tricep push-up, straight back up. So that's how you can prepare for Chaturanga at the wall. Once you've mastered that at the wall and you feel like that's pretty easy, take your relationship to gravity lower. So find a chair or a bench that you can do that with. Do the exact same thing. Keep one long line from the crown of the head all the way to the heels. Keep the elbows in tight, lower the chest between the hands, push straight back up. And we'll do the same thing on the mat.